What does it mean to play Vienna?
I don't know.
I mean, to play here, I mean, the Opera House is a really special place. I knew it when I walked into it last summer when we did it with Black Country Queen, arguably a very strange gig for that band, but we did it nonetheless. And I knew it was a special place, and I knew it was had a magic vibe to it. And if you look around, what does it look like? It looks like a small version of the Albert Hall. And it kind of sounds like a small version of the Albert Hall. Has a nice echo to it, but not too much. Has a nice natural top end to it. And, you know, I mean, Vienna, of all places, you know, we hadn't played Vienna. I mean, this would be the first time we've ever played Vienna as a solo artist. And arguably, this is a completely different project than we've done ever. So I think this was like, it was a real no-brainer, and it's a real honor and a privilege to play here. You know, you could just say, you know, you could say how many people could say that they play the Vienna Opera House, you know, on their own terms, you know, and part of a special project like this. And, you know, they only open up this place to outside acts, class, you know, non-classical stuff for 3 weeks a year. This is part of the Jazz Fest, so we're not jazz, but we're not blues rock either today. So it's special, it's fun.
Nobody's even met each other yet. The first date is in about 10 days. We've got an Irish mandolin player, a Swedish traditional nickel harpy player, Lenny Castro plays percussion, Arlen is playing keyboards, and Joe playing acoustic guitar only. And we're going to go and redo only acoustic versions of some of the songs.
Pat Foley and the fine folks at Gibson in Bozeman, Montana were nice enough to send three guitars for the tour to go along with the other stuff we have. And it's a nice J200, a beautiful advanced jumbo on the floor there, and a Gibson Hummingbird, which is really nice. So, and it's, so I think it'd be awesome. Sensitive version. Slow G.
A minor?
Well, we have been planning it for a while. I'm not sure when the Vienna Opera House was booked. I know BCC played there last year.
I got this really wicked one I sent over already. It's a J45, but it's got the Tree of Life in the fretboard.
Are you having me on?
Sounds awesome.
Are you having me on?
They probably had a look at the venue and thought that it was amazing. And once we had it in play, I got together with Joe and we ran down a list of songs that would have been good to do acoustic-wise. And pretty much until he got off his tour in June, he didn't look at it, and then he had a week off at home and he looked at it and he ran over the tunes on his own with acoustic guitar. And I put a little band together around him and arranged these unique instruments to kind of suit his songs.
Yeah, and our thing is like it's a bluegrass gig. We kept telling like sound guys and all that because they come out of Nashville. And then it's a bluegrass gig. It's really a bluegrass gig.
Right.
Essentially, only it's these guys don't come from Kentucky.
Exactly.
Yeah.
I think the Irish guy is going to be a secret weapon. I think.
And a great drinker.
No, actually, he's the same age as me, so he's an old man.
A great drinker, then.
A great drinker.
Experience.
But
he can pace himself.
He's a musicologist and a musical historian of Irish stuff.
Oh, I better get my baron.
Exactly. And I think we'll need it in some places, especially like in the Battle for Hatred's Wall.
I think I'm going to bring a couple, because I have one that's a small one, but I got to bring a bigger one that's a little deeper, just to have it.
So this is the guy. He plays Irish banjo and...
What technique? That's a whole different technique.
That's why I'm so...
It's not Nashville or anything. It was just a whole...
That's why... That's why it's... They keep calling me and they say, are we ready? And I say, to be honest, we're a little bit of a crapshoot because all I can do is put together the guys that I think will make a nice soup, and then I got to see what's going to come out of that.
Hope that, yeah.
Everyone is that good that I know when we put them in a room together, everyone's got the music, everyone's going to play something.
Yeah.
My job at that point is just to say, you're not in this song, or you're not in this song.
Yeah.
And that's just I like what you're doing, but it's not in the song, and
right.
I've got to make sure we have colors, but I'm not worried about
that. Well, that's why I'm making sure that I know everything. I mean, I know you stipulated which ones that had percussion, but you know what? I'm going to familiarize myself with everything.
Exactly.
Just in case you say, I think we need something now. Thank you.